Childhood of Jesus, Chapter 221. The same conditions do not apply everywhere. After Jonathan was thus enlightened, as well as all those present, Joseph suggested, "Friends, it is a beautiful evening. How would it be if before going to our night's rest we went out into the open for an hour? For it is extremely sultry in these rooms, and if one goes to bed now, one can neither rest nor sleep." Here the little child said, "Joseph, I'm of that opinion too. Only there should not be so many bothersome insects buzzing around outside. Then it would be more pleasant to be outside in the evening." And Joseph agreed, "Yes, my life, there you are indeed right. If there were only a means by which it were possible to get rid of these bothersome little guests without going against your order, that would be most desirable." And the little child replied, "Oh, such a means can no doubt be found quickly. Go and get a bowl full of warm cow's milk and put it outside, and you will see how all these thousands upon thousands of bothersome little guests will surround the bowl and will leave us in peace." Joseph now promptly told his sons to put a bowl of warm cow's milk outside, and the sons quickly carried out Joseph's wish. And when the bowl of warm milk had been placed into the open, an enormous swarm of all manner of stinging insects soon appeared above the milk bowl in the faint evening twilight. All were surprised at this ingenuity by which millions of midges and gnats gathered together at one point and there waged a veritable milk war with each other. At this, Cyrenius asserted, "See how simple and really practical this measure is. A hardly noticeable bowl full of warm milk frees us from the bothersome nuisance of insects. Truly, that shall soon be carried out entire also, for there millions of such creatures annoy the people in the evening." And the little child stated, "The means is indeed quite good, but it will not be possible to apply it everywhere successfully, for the same conditions do not apply everywhere, and such conditions as are now to be found here probably do not exist anywhere else. Therefore, this remedy works so excellently only here, for where these conditions are not to be found, this remedy would not work so well either. Now look up to the sky, and you will discover a comet." Hereat, Cyrenius looked upward, and at once saw a large comet. The Childhood of Jesus, Chapter 222. When Zero Counts as Much as a Million. When Cyrenius had taken a good long look at the large comet, he declared, "Truly an unusual star. It is the first one I have seen, but I have of course heard of these mythical bearers of ill tidings in the sky a number of times." At this remark of Cyrenius, Maronius Pillar also came over and asserted, "Just look at that. The temple of Janus is hardly closed 7 years, and everyone said, now Rome will have eternal peace, for it is said that this temple has never been closed this long. And now we already have the terrible sign in front of our eyes that the temple of Janus will be unlocked again quite soon, and that matters will become very lively on the great fields of Mars." Joseph then asked Maronius Pillar if he really considered such a comet to be a harbinger of war. And Maronius Pillar replied quite seriously, "Oh, friend, that is an unalterably truth. I tell you, war upon war." Here Cyrenius remarked, "Now we have the right pair together for once. Joseph still holds mightily to his Moses, and Maronius Pillar cannot get rid of his old heathenish superstition." At this Joseph protested, "Esteemed friend and brother Cyrenius, I would say that Moses is surely better than the temple of Janus in Rome." And Cyrenius retorted, "Of course. But if one has the Lord Jehovah himself in his fullness, I would say that Moses as well as the dull Janus should step quite far into the background, and that once and for all. The comet, according to ancient unfounded fables, does indeed seem to be a bearer of ill tidings, but I believe that our dearest Jesus and Lord in the fullness of his deity also happens to be a Lord over this supposed Lord of misfortune. Do you not agree with me? And Joseph answered, That surely. But for all that, Moses is still not to be compared with the Janus of Rome, not even in this presence of the Lord. Cyrenius agreed, I do not want to do that either, but if I have the Lord, then at least to me Moses and Janus are the same. Here the little child said to Cyrenius, Stay with that, for truly, where infinity is concerned, all magnitudes fade, and zero counts as much as a million. This answer of the little child jarred Joseph a bit, and thereafter he did not uphold Moses to Cyrenius any more. Chapter 223, A Comet in Miniature. Jonathan, who on such occasions always delved strongly into the cause, now came to Joseph and said, Brother, here is something else again, where the Lord, as recently at the eclipse of the moon, could straighten us out. Do you suppose that he would enlighten us if we ask him about it? Joseph answered, My dear brother Jonathan, the matter needs only to be put to the test. Whoever puts all his trust in the Lord builds on a firm foundation. Go over to the little child who is now on Mary's lap and ask him, and you will soon receive an answer to your question. Upon this reply, Jonathan at once, in all love and humility, went over to the little child and wanted to ask. But the little child anticipated Jonathan and said, Jonathan, I already know what you want, but that is too deep for you. Go into the house now and take a small torch, light it, and then go with the burning torch over to the milk bowl that has been set out for the midges and gnats. And I tell you, there you will also see a comet as well as its fundamental nature. At this, Jonathan quickly did what the little child had advised him to do. And lo, when he brought the burning torch close to the milk bowl, a buff with millions of flies, mosquitoes, and gnats circled about. He there discovered a long shimmering tail, consisting of the flying insects, which was several fathoms long, and of which the milk bowl formed the head. This phenomenon was also seen by many other people, and all were amazed at the similarity of this affected appearance with the comet in the sky. Hereupon Jonathan went over to the little child and asked him how he was to understand this. And the little child answered, For the time being just as you have seen it, not everyone may know this secret, so be satisfied with that for now. Tomorrow will be another day.